What do we know about Area 51? Area 51 refers to a map location and is the popular name for a United States Air Force base. It is at Groom Lake, a dry lake bed in the Nevada desert, 85 miles, 135 kilometers north of Las Vegas. What goes on inside is extremely secret. Members of the public are kept away by warning signs, electronic surveillance, and armed guards. It is also illegal to fly over Area 51, although the site is now visible on satellite images. Though, for decades, Nevada's Area 51 Air Force facility has represented the eye of a conspiratorial hurricane that swirls around evidence that aliens exist and are hiding behind its walls. Books, TV shows, and even massive online raids have tried to glimpse beyond its stark signs warning against trespassers. Before World War II, the area near Groom Lake was used for silver and lead mining. Once the war began, the military took over the remote area and began conducting research, mainly nuclear and weapons testing. In 1989, Bob Lazar, an American conspiracy theorist, claimed that he had worked at Area 51 Sector 4, said to be located underground, inside the Papoose Range near Papoose Lake. He claimed that he was contracted to work with alien spacecraft that the government had in its possession. Similarly, the 1996 documentary Dreamland, directed by Bruce Burgess, included an interview with a 71-year-old mechanical engineer who claimed to be a former employee at Area 51 during the 1950s. His claims included that he had worked on a flying disc simulator, which had been based on a disc originating from a crashed extraterrestrial craft, and was used to train pilots. He also claimed to have worked with an extraterrestrial being named J-Rod and described as a telepathic translator in 2004. Dan Berish, pseudonym of Dan Crane, claimed to have worked on cloning alien viruses at Area 51, also alongside the alien named J-Rod. Berish's scholarly credentials are the subject of much debate, as he was apparently working as a Las Vegas parole officer in 1989, while also earning a Ph.D. at State University of New York. As if crashed UFOs weren't enough, some conspiracy theorists also think that Area 51 is where the moon landing was staged. In the 1974 book, We Never Went to the Moon, America's $30 Billion Swindle, conspiracy theorist Bill Kaysing argues that NASA astronauts never made it to space and that all the footage of Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin walking on the lunar surface was filmed at Area 51. In 2019, more than 2 million people have signed up during the past 2 months to converge on Area 51, the airbase near Rachel, Nevada, with hopes of seeing aliens. Although the organizer has called the Storm Area 51 event a hoax, city officials estimate that 30,000 to 40,000 people could show up this weekend. Area 51 is on the map, but good luck actually getting there. It's a restricted area, with armed guards patrolling the fences around the perimeter. They're colloquially known as camo dudes, because that's what they wear when on the job. Given the testing of stealth aircraft on the site, this kind of secrecy isn't very surprising. In 2016, Google Earth images revealed a mysterious mile-long landing strip in Area 6 of the Yucca Flat test site, about 12 miles northeast of Area 51. A handful of hangars cluster at one end of the runway. Nothing is known about exactly what is being tested at the airstrip, but the Department of Defense and the Department of Homeland Security both use the site. Security experts told Live Science that the site might be used to test reconnaissance drones and their sensors. Area 51 is still an active base developing cutting-edge military technology. Historians know what type of aircraft was being developing until the 1970s, but after that, it's a top-secret mystery. The site continues to be a pillar of U.S. alien mythology. A recent interview with Lazar on a popular podcast inspired the Storm Area 51 event, which has since morphed into a festival celebrating all things alien. Even without the event, Area 51 draws believers and skeptics who frequent the small but thriving trail of alien-themed museums, restaurants, motels, parades, and festivals. Meanwhile, people in the southern Nevada region continue to report UFO sightings, which in hindsight were probably sightings of the top-secret spy planes being constructed. Even so, Imaginations have run wild ever since. What do you think of Area 51? Let us know in the comments.